story time anytime, so cheers!
Hello, welcome back, Storytime Anytime viewers. Thank you so much for joining us for today's story. Now, do you share a birthday that's around a special event? Well, that's what today's book's about. It's called A Birthday Fairy Tale and it's written by Megan Pighetti and illustrated by Yuliana Simakovska. Let's go have a listen.
A Birthday Fairy Tale.
Am I the only one who sees it?
Reese asked. No one had mentioned her birthday was tomorrow. Tomorrow!
December birthdays are the worst.
Reese's loose tooth rubbed her tongue as she strung beads with her brother, Charlie.
One final touch,
Reese said, holding out the biggest, shiniest bead.
Mine!
Charlie said, grabbing the bead out of Reese's fingers. Charlie grinned as he placed it on his pipe cleaner. Reese slumped. She did not like battling over a bead. Rummaging through the container, she found the only glow-in-the-dark butterfly bead.
Perfection!
Reese dashed away, ready to show it off. Mum was distracted. Dad was working.
No one cared about her bracelet. No one cared about her birthday. And no one cared about her.
Alone in bed on her birthday eve, she sniffed.
How could they all forget?
Reese rubbed her beads and wiggled her loose tooth with her tongue. With tears in her eyes, she whispered,
"Maybe I should just pack up and move to the treehouse."
She tiptoed out of bed, pulled out her suitcase, and put on her favorite dress.
Fairy wings, stuffed animals, books, my tutu. Wait a minute, I can't forget my tooth fairy pillow. Aha!
She bounced from toe to toe.
There must be a birthday fairy too. How can I bring the birthday fairy to me?
The glow of her perfect butterfly bead caught her eye.
Of course, my bracelet.
Reese crept into the hall and stood at her door. She hugged the bracelet and whispered a wish.
I wish with all my might for the birthday fairy to come tonight.
Leaving the door cracked, Reese yawned and shoved her suitcase under the bed. She snuggled beneath her covers. Hope was all she needed to enter dreamland. When the sun peeped through the window, Reese's eyes fluttered open.
It's more than I dreamed,
she squealed with delight. Toilet paper tails flowed around the room as if silently singing, "Happy birthday to you." Ready for Reese to spin it through like a tornado. Or better yet, treasure for days to come. Once her excitement bubbled to the brim, she gracefully escaped to find Charlie.
Charlie, come and see my room. The birthday fairy came.
Charlie's jaw dropped in awe at the toilet paper tangled room.
No way, there's a birthday fairy too?
He squealed. But Reese had already danced off to find Mum and Dad.
Mum! Dad!
Reese sang, sliding into the kitchen, only to discover no one had forgotten her birthday after all. You've made your wish, I'm on my way. Zoom through the night for your birthday. Up and down in your room, I'll sail over and under till you're fairy-tailed.
Thank you for sticking around for today's story. Make sure you watch all the other stories on our channel and press the little red subscribe button down the bottom. We'll see you next time.